These guys, as young as they are very confident.
Oh my goodness, no.
They're almost fearless.
How do I stand? This is awkward.
What's the script?
It's not an easy job, but I think the candidates this year have been phenomenal. Our expectations are quite high. Not only the discipline of accounting is what we're looking at, but also the overall CSI achievements and, you know, sort of what they've given back.
Those judges are tough.
They made me nervous.
That's what they get paid to do.
I think the only thing that calmed me down was the coffee. The cappuccino that was brought in.
That means I need to know their names, right?
Andy Lekumalo, definitely. I think maybe because of his profile. I mean, everybody sitting in that room has a very high impact profile, but his is just, it's massive. So definitely Andile.
I'd say Abed made me very nervous.
Abed made me the most nervous. He was pretty straightforward with his question.
What's your view on the consumer in Africa?
For some reason, we just find amazing people.
What?
Really?
And CAs are so diverse.
Your mama's rich and your pa is good looking.
They do so many different things, from public practice to audit to entrepreneurship type of roles. So it's just amazing. And to see the youth and the young people come through is just really encouraging.
I'm the group head of mergers and acquisitions at Transaction Capital Risk Services.
I look after the finance function of FedEx Express.
The CFO of King Price Insurance. We launched 7 years ago and we're changing the way insurance is done in the South African market.
My name is Lerato Msivi. I'm currently a senior manager for forensic services and head of investigations for MTN Group.
I'm a senior lecturer at the University of Johannesburg, currently lecturing postgraduate accounting.
Hi, my name is Han Billingen. First things first, she said yes and I'm getting married. Woo! Apart from that, I'm also the co-founder of JobJack as well as the director of JobAble. And our vision is to employ the world starting right here in Mzansi, at the tip of Africa.
This country is set up for great success because of the young CAs that we have in this country that are doing such great things.
Being partner at Deloitte at the age of 30, that for me was a career highlight. And then most recently, being appointed to the Alexander Forbes Group.
The CASA brand is a coveted brand that I had wanted ever since I was in school, and it means for me a leader in business, a leader in society, and a leader of self.
The CASA brand is, I mean, it means everything to me. It's got me to where I am today in a business world, and I'm proud to be a CASA.
I think a CA, not only the skills that it gives you to actually attack and build and grow a business, but it's also the brand around it and the fact that you can really do anything without any limits.
What this means for the CA brand, hopefully, is that we remain on top of our game, because our entrants and all the applicants are coming from various walks of life. They're not only in business, they're not only in academia, they're doing so much for their community. Some of them are following their passions in all sorts of different spheres.
So I think our most recent career highlight, we're opening up a new store, our 10th store in South Africa in a couple of weeks. And I think another sort of career highlight is we recently did a collaboration with Siya Kolisi, the Springbok rugby captain, where we developed a proudly South African shoe, and the proceeds from the shoe, sale of the shoe, will be used to resurface and rebuild a sports field at the Mbokweni Youth Centre in Paarl. So it's been a great project.
My most significant career highlight is being nominated as one of Africa's brightest young minds, being promoted to vice president at one of the biggest banks in South Africa.
So I think my biggest highlight was definitely being hand selected by the tech giant Google to represent the agency landscape in South Africa at the launch of the Google Partners program in Nigeria. It was a really inspiring and inspiring trip where I went over to Lagos, Nigeria to deliver a keynote on how to grow a successful business with Google as a partner.
Good gracious, my most significant career highlight recently is a financial close of $500 million worth of solar and wind facilities last year, July 2018.
So I think what I'm looking for is essentially the three elements, the way they've developed professionally, their ability to influence, or the way that they're currently influencing business as well as the society that we live in, and really the impact that they make to people around them.
The recent career achievement was being invited to the Forbes Africa Women Leading Women Summit as one of the young intellectuals.
As judges, what we're looking for is we're looking for inspirational leaders, people who live the ethos of being a chartered accountant.
I entered because I believed in terms of some of the work that we are doing at the public sector, some of the work that I'm doing with my team is great work, and that story needs to be shared with many others.
And the CA brand, it's a brand that's full of integrity. It's a brand that's full of quality. It's a brand of excellence.
But more importantly, we want to understand how chartered accountants can not only be a beacon of hope, but lead us to take people to the next level.
My strengths as a leader is leading by an example, demonstrating on a daily basis that as young leaders, we can accomplish, be accountable, as well as have integrity.
My definition for success is setting an almost unachievable goal for yourself and then achieving that goal. That is success.
And also just being able to give back what you have learned, to just plow back.
So for me, success, it means being able to touch the other person's heart and take them a step further, and which is why I'm doing all the work I'm doing with my family in terms of developing the communities.
I think the definition of success is staying true and authentic to yourself, irrespective of the level of accolades that you receive as a person.
It's been exceptional. So it's my first year on the panel, and it's really been great. Some of these guys who are CFA, CA, MBA, really they don't even have time for anything else in their lives, but they really do balance their life.
Having the time and ability to celebrate the successes you have is equally as important as being successful.
What does the CSA brand mean to me? It's a personal brand. It's something that we live with and we live by on a day-to-day basis.
You've achieved them, and you're ready to dream bigger, and you get to that space. But while you're doing that, you're actually bringing others along. You leave a trail so that someone can follow through on that. That's real success for me.
South Africa, that regardless of where you come from, regardless of what you do, whether numbers or not numbers, you can do whatever you want, whatever you aspire to be.
And this whole process actually makes you do it. And like their slogan is, exceptional without exception. And that's what it is. Like, the people that I've met today have been exceptional beyond imagination.
Because my mom told me so.
It was about the money.
Ching ching!
I became a CA because I was told that CAs would be rich.
Ching ching!
In school, we were told that to become very wealthy very quickly, either become a doctor or become a CA.
Ching ching!
Those who wish to study the CA route, I strongly suggest it.
And I always take up any challenge, try and go to the fullest length. So when I started to study accounting and I heard what it means to be a CA, I just carry on and went for it.
Being part of the top 35, you are the captains of industry. You are the people in business that are going to lead this country into the future.
Success for me is impact. It's using all the gifts you've been given to make an impact on the world and achieve your hopes and dreams.
And all I say is to those that are out there is to keep on entering, because your message is what people need to listen to and be inspired by your story.
Look, I think if you can achieve being nominated and actually winning this, it will show people that the CA route is not dead, and it will highlight your career. It will show that what you've done and what all through studying, through articles, all the work you've done, someone appreciates out there.
Whoa, I'm always in trouble with CPD.
Great.
Oh my gosh.
We lost our new CPD.
Yes.
you're proud of what you've done, then show it out to the world and encourage other people that have actually, you know, lost any hope, and give them that hope that actually you can do it. You just need to be an ordinary person to see value and see things differently and keep adding value into other people's lives.
My strengths as a leader, I think specifically around being very fast-paced and being open to new ideas. I love experimenting, and so I don't take it very personally when things fail specifically within the business, because the ultimate thing is for us to grow and to innovate, and that requires experimenting.
They're going to be met with a lot of situations where that fearlessness must come through. That ability not to be fazed or intimidated by a situation or by an individual is going to come through, where you need to stand up for the right thing.
My strengths as a leader is that I do my best to understand the problems that I'm trying to solve. Secondly, I understand that I'm not solving these problems for myself, but for the people that are affected by these problems.
So being a CA to me means so much more than just being an accountant. It means being a leader in all aspects of your life, on personal level and in business. And also being an entrepreneur and just going for whatever it is that you believe that you can achieve.
The candidate who won and the other awards are always brilliant, and it's always hard to look at those that didn't win, because you know all 35 have made it through a tough process already. But I think we got the right winner this year.